8 strange places of worship. On number 8, Shri Dev Vetoba Temple. Almost every Indian kid has read the stories of Vikram and Vetal, but here in Shiroda, Maharashtra, Vetal becomes Vetoba, the king of ghosts. At the temple said to be constructed in 1600, devotees pray to Vetoba to bring them enlightenment, for removing the evil within them or just for blessings. Vetoba, however, accepts a different kind of offering too, local leather chappals. It is believed that Vetoba wears these chappals when he sets out to patrol and protect the village from evil. Apparently, the soles of these offered chappals were found worn out in just a few days, as Vetoba keeps walking around the village in his daily patrols. On number 7, Karni Mata Temple. 30 km away from Bikaner, Rajasthan, in the town of Deshnoke, is the Karni Mata Mandir. Here the rats in the temple are worshipped, fed, and their leftover food is considered as good as prasad. It is said that the temple houses 20,000 rats in all. What's the story? Apparently the local deity Karni Mata asked the god of death Yama to revive a son of one of the Charan caste's member. Some say Yama refused but then relented. Some say Karni Mata herself did something. Also known as the storyteller caste, the members of the Charan caste from then on were reincarnated as rats, and after they died again would be reincarnated as the members of the Depavats family. On number 6, Key Monastery. Said to be founded in the 11th century, the Key Monastery in the Spiti Valley began as a Tibetan Buddhist monastery training lamas. But in the following years and decades, it kept facing foreign attacks. From the Mongols to the Dogras to the Sikhs to fire and even an earthquake. The monastery was damaged and destroyed countless times, but every time it kept rebuilding on top of the damaged portions. Today the monastery houses 250 lamas. It also has hidden courtyards, underground rooms and many other marvels, the product of its past. On number 5, Mahabat Makbara. What can you say about the Mahabat Makbara? The mosque and the mausoleum in the complex were built in 1878 with the architectural influences of the European and Indo-Islamic styles melded wonderfully. The mausoleum in fact is of Wazir Bahaduddin Bhai Hussain Bhai, one of the nobles serving in the kingdom of Junagadh. Among the compliments received, it has been called otherworldly and the stuff that dreams are made of. We wholeheartedly agree. On number 4, Tashding Monastery. The Tashding Monastery in Sikkim has, like all other places of worship, various origin stories. Some talk of a divine arrow, some talk of the appearance of a bright light. But the most unusual occurrence in present times is of an annual event held in the monastery where an auspicious vase is opened. Sealed throughout the year, the vase is opened only during the Bhuchu festival and the water level inside is inspected. If full, a prosperous year is predicted, if low, famine is predicted, and if the vase is empty, the year ahead is going to be dire. On number 3, Shatrunjay Hill. This pilgrimage site for Jains in Gujarat reportedly has more than 1000 temples, all of them built with marble, bronze or stone. But to reach these temples, you have to climb 3950 steps, and to do things the proper way, you have to visit all the temples. More than that, it is said to be auspicious if a Jain manages to climb the mountain 99 times during his lifetime. On number 2, Tower of Silence. The Zoroastrians have their own ways of bidding goodbye to the dead. This involves leaving the body of the dead out in the open for the purpose of scavenger birds like vultures to purify their bodies. After this, the bones would be collected and kept in an ossuary. In Mumbai, the Zoroastrian burial site is within a 54-acre forest called the Tower of Silence. On number 1, Basilica of Bom Jesus. By all accounts, Francis Xavier had an enterprising life, converting natives to Christianity from India to Japan to China, but in death, he became something even more. Buried in the basilica, the body is kept inside a glass cask and is permitted for public viewing once in 10 years. Before though, the body was kept out permanently with the feet out in the open air. But in 1554, a worshipper while kissing the saint's feet bit off a toe. Promptly, blood is said to have gushed out from the wound like a living man's wound. In 1619, Francis Xavier was declared as a saint by the church. Prior to this, his right arm, which he used to grant blessings, was detached and taken to Rome. Thanks for watching. Drop a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe for such amazing videos.